invented by Gainsborough in 1747 and acquired by the 36th Earl of Warwick in 1821. Where we're standing now, ladies and gentlemen, is the main hall of the castle. This here is Thomas de Newburgh, born round about 1213, died 1297. Sixth Earl of Warwick.
Hey, you're an American, I see.
That's right. Hartford, Connecticut. Have you heard of it?
Ah, born there. Born and raised in Hartford. Know it well. Oh, it's a long, long time since I last saw it. That was in 1889.
Come now, sir. 1889 was but a few short years ago.
Ah, sir, but my journey was not in a straight line, either in geography or time.
Pardon me. What was that again?
You've heard of the transmigration of soul? Have you ever heard of the transposition of a man's body in time and place?
Afraid I didn't quite catch that. Mind repeating it?
This here is an ancient suit of armor, date of the 6th century, time of King Arthur at Camelot. Now, here's a puzzler and no mistake. Please be so good as to observe this 32 caliber bullet hole. Now I ask you, whoever put a bullet hole in this here piece of armor back there in the days of the crossbow and King Arthur?
Which, well, I saw it done.
Did you indeed? You what?
As a matter of fact, I did it myself.
Now, if you will follow me, please, we'll have a walk through the main banquet in all itself, famous for its eye ceiling, its inlaid floor, and the hook.
As I said, sir, I am an American, born and bred in Hartford, Connecticut, the nutmeg state, a Yankee of the Yankees. Worked in the factory there, the arms factory. You know of it, don't you? Yes. Well, I suppose I knew all there was to know about guns and engines and boilers and all kinds of machinery. Why, I could make anything in the world a body wanted. And if something was wanted that hadn't been made yet, I could invent that too. I read the world's almanac from cover to cover. Lucky thing for me I did, because I kept a copy by me in case some argument came up. And there was a lot of arguments too. Oh yes, believe me. Because you see, I was head superintendent of the place with a couple of thousand men under me. And in a position like that, trouble comes easily. Well, sir, one day I...
My fault, is it? Come on up close to me and say that, Hank Morgan.
Close enough, Peggy Mace. Those pistols came off your bench. They're defective. You're fired.
Is that so, huh?
Look out!
That crowbar connected. That's all I knew for a good long time. When I came to again, I was sitting under a tree on the side of a hill, with a beautiful country landscape all to myself. Well, nearly all to myself.
Yes, sir. Will you just?
Will I which?
Will you try a passage of arms? Or land, or lady, or what you will?
Friend, I don't know how you got over that asylum wall with all that kitchenware on you, but you better get back or I'll report you.
Don't refuse my challenge. Prepare to defend thyself.
By golly, that one's dangerous. I wonder if the alarm is out for him yet.
I claim this my prisoner. We'll come quietly, or just to seek further argument.
No, I ain't budging out of this street till they find out you've escaped and send a guard after you.
I'll just defy me!
Oh, go easy with that hardware. Good heavens, here. Thanks, here comes the posse now. This way, fellas!
If you could then, Sir Sagramore.
Where came you by this creature?
Take him in charge, Page, and witch you now guard him well. He is the prisoner of my sword.
And it pleased him, my lord.
That's right, sir. Humor him.
Hey, you are one of the prison asylum guards, aren't you?
Oh, matter fair, sir. Me seemeth.
That's enough. I reckon you're one of the patients, too.
Untree the monster!
All right. I'm coming down.
Well, I reckon these folks ain't
Thank patients from the asylum after all. I reckon it's me that somehow got into the place. Look, son, you seem a little saner than the others. How do I get in touch with the head keeper?
Oh, prithee, do not let me.
Let you what?
Hinder me, then, if it please thee better. We must needs proceed on our journey at once.
Our journey? Where we go? Hartford?
Yonder.
Oh, Bridgeport, huh?
Do you not see yon battlements? Is not the castle at Camelot?
Is not? Or is't it?
Thus for thine eyes averted, whilst I cast a spell to make harmless the powers of this evil sorcerer.
Hey, get me out of here.
Get me out of here! Now I have cast my spell and thou mayst gaze with impunity. Didst ever see the like?
'Tis somewhat like a man, yet withal not like a man.
Who, me? Oh, now, just a minute.
What barbarous language is this? 'Tis the tongue of the wicked magicians of Modair. Look, you, how this evil one wears the clothing of a sorcerer.
But what is the purpose of yon inverted bathing bowl which resteth upon his head?
Verily, 'tis a most ingenious device which, upon removal, doth cause flames to spout forth from the pate.
Verily?
Excuse me, ma'am. The name is Morgan, Hank Morgan, from Hartford, Connecticut. The nutmeg stage.
I saw no flames. Tis well. Thou seest now how I have rendered him harmless? I must hurry me to fetch King Arthur that he may marvel at my wondrous powers.
King Arthur? Hey, you, miss. Come here.
Is it safe?
Where am I?
Why, marry, sir, knowest not thou art in the dungeon at King Arthur's court?
King Arthur's court, huh? Tell me, which way is up? And down. Yes. Now, how do I get out of here? Never mind. Look. Think hard. What date is today?
Well, marry, sir, twin on the street, you know what day it is. It is the 21st day of the month of June in the year 528.
528, eh?
Oh, in sooth, this I know, gentle sir. For being born the same day of June in the year 513.
No. Wait a minute. Cut it out. You mean to stand there and tell me that you were born in the year 513? No. You don't look it.
Oh, you mad, sir. And now it's laugh. Well, then listen to me well. For I have a jape to split your side. Well, ready? Right, so it happened that upon a recent journey I did encounter a nobleman of my acquaintance whom I recalled I had observed upon a previous even in the company of a good woman whose name and features I knew not. Well, good day, noble sir, quoth I. Prithee tell me, who was that good woman with whom I perceived thee but yester-eve? Whereupon quoth the noble knight, that were no good woman, that were my wife!
That settles it. No more, do you understand? I'm not going to stand here in my own dream and hear that one again. This must be a nightmare.
And aside, that I may gaze upon this monstrous demon.
Then it please your majesty, do not all at once gaze full upon him, lest the shock be too great.
Boop! A most pitiful spectacle. And yet, methinks the poor creature doth bear some distant kinship with mankind. would be a kindness to burn it alive.
Oh, no, no, not my own dream. No, no, sirree, Your Majesty. Thanks just the same for your kindness.
Aye, my liege, he must be burned at the stake, and that quickly, too, ere he regain his evil power and destroy us all. And then, please your grace, we will burn him at the stake at high noon this very day.
Now, look here. I'm going to count up the three of you here. And when I open my eyes, you're all going to be gone. At the count of three, I'm going to be back in the factory and finish my fight with Hercules. You ready? One, two, three. Well, maybe it is the 21st of June, 528. But 1,300 years from now, when you're dead and forgotten, I'm going to be hanging around the corner store in Hartford, Connecticut, the Nutmeg State. And if you think for one moment that you're going to burn me at the stake, ha ha ha,
doubt it not, fair sir. Monster and be done with it.
At once, Your Majesty.
Hey, you, whatever
your
name is.
I'm called Alessandra, gentlemen.
Well, Sandy, what are you trembling for? It's only a dream.
Nay, it is no dream. And thou art undone.
I wish I were undone. Clarence, my boy, you don't happen to have a knife handy.
Oh, la, sir. Know thee not thy bonds, but the trappings of the ceremony. And worthy of the merest gossamer, yet thou couldst not move. Well, Merlin hath cast a spell over thee.
Oh, yes, eh? Well, I'm a bit of a magician myself. And if you'll just slip me a knife, I'll show that chuckle-headed old humbug a trick or two.
Oh, I dare not.
There's life for you. I don't suppose anybody in the world ever had an opportunity like this. Here I am in the 6th century with a 19th century brain. Why, I could be boss of this country in 6 months, and here I am. Going to be burnt to the stake before I have a chance to get started.
Now, where is that Merlin? I grow weary with waiting and faint for lack of food and drink. Is not high noon? Over, Merlin! Well.
All is in readiness, my liege.
On with it, then, on with it.
Where's the torch?
The torch?
Fetch it, idiot! Fetch it!
Oh, sir, all but the torch is in readiness. I do fear thy day is come.
Well, if I can help it. June 21st, 528. There's something about that date.
Look ye, how the sky grows dark. And the very sun would fain hide from this cruel deed.
Sandy! You've saved the day. Now I remember. World Almanac, page 301. The first recorded eclipse of the sun happened on June 21st, 528 A.D., 3 minutes past noon. I told you I knew my almanac.
Make way! Apply the torch! The torch, I say!
I forbid it!
What's this?
If any man take one step before I get him leave, the very heavens will consume him with thunder and lightning. Ooh. Look and take heed!
This sorcerer is truly helpless.
Indeed, my liege, he is quite disarmed.
Helpless am I? Look at the sky, look. Disarmed am I? Why, that old fuddy-duddy Merlin couldn't disarm a bumblebee. I've got some A1 magic in my bag of tricks. Now you just watch this one.
No!
What art thou doing to the sky?
I'm going to smother the whole world in the deep blackness of midnight. The fruits of the earth shall rot for lack of light and warmth, and the people of the earth shall famish and die. Oh, I'm riled up now, Your Majesty, and just to show you and your boyfriends how to have some manners, I'm going to blot out the sun. Abracadabra!
Be merciful, great sorcerer. Of thy kingdom, but banish this calamity. Spare the sun.
Oh, sir, thou hast him at thy mercy. Pray, heed their cries. Bid the spell cease.
We beseech thee, gentle sir, the sun is near blotted out.
Abracadabra!
Thy name, thy terms, in heaven's name, thy terms.
All right, Your Majesty, these are my terms. You shall remain your dominions and receive all the honor and glory that goes with kingship. But I will become your perpetual minister and executive, and you will give me leave to make whatever changes in the kingdom that I see fit. From now out, I'm boss around here.
Tis done, Sir Boss. Wipe away this creeping night and restore light and cheer that all the world may bless thee.
Okay, Your Majesty, let the enchantment dissolve and pass harmless away.
And do homage high and low, rich and poor, for he has become Sir Boss, the king's right hand.
Well, it's a bargain, Your Majesty. There's nothing in the world I like so much as a good bargain. Why, we'll have this place showing a neat little profit before you can say, nutmeg!
Faith, Sir Boss, scarce can I contain myself till this wondrous carbuncle is explained.
You know, Your Majesty, I never saw such a place for people to stay up all night. I'm afraid to go to sleep for fear somebody's going to sneak up behind them with a knife. Well, I'm going to put an end to that right now. Observe, please.
Gods, venison on thy enchantment.
Ah, you get the point. You know, Your Majesty, the smallest child in my hometown could rig up a gadget like that. In fact, most of us did.
And now I may sleep my fill, safe in the knowledge that none may enter unobserved.
That's right, Your Majesty.
Ah, here indeed is a wondrous enchantment. I prithee, let me hear it again.
At yourself.
Will work my command, being no sorcerer?
Oh, yes, it was a little special kind of magic I ran up just so you could operate it without any trouble.
Ah, very. Have at it, then. Miraculous happening! Ah, here is a charm that delighteth me greatly. I prithee, sir, get thee on the other side while I remain here and counterfeit sleep. Then, when thou thinkest me slumbering, open the door and essay to steal upon me unaware.
Okay, Your
attend,
Majesty.
Attend, sir, attend.
If you please, Your Majesty.
Miraculous charm.
Good morrow, good my lord.
Hello,
what are you up to?
No,
don't tell me. Right now I'm playing hide and seek with King Arthur. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not, I'm coming.
Aha! The intended assassin, and will rue thy foolhardiness ere thou diest. By my faith, Sir Boss, it lacketh nothing, this enchantment of thine.
Yeah, well, I'm mighty glad it pleases your majesty.
Pleases me? Never have my eyes beheld its fellow for delight. I prithee, sir, let us do it again. This time I will be you, and you me, and I...
But if I might be excused, your majesty, I have some very important matters to attend to.
And it please thee, Sir Boss. Wondrous. How say you, Sir Boss? Canst place such a tongue as this on every tree in England, that I may ride the land without fear of ambuscade?
I'm working on something for that very purpose, but it's a little more ambitious than these gadgets and takes more time. It's called the telephone.
Telephone? Ah, there is a word to conjure with, surely.
Your Majesty, you can sit right here, do a day's work, and yet know everything that's going on anywhere in the kingdom. You don't have to go off on one of these wild goose chases because Sir Sagamore thinks there's dragons coming.
Why, Sir Boss, wouldst deprive the nobles of Britain of the chase? Me fear the time would hang heavy on our hands.
But you'll be busy answering the phones. Besides, we're going to go to work here and bring about something in this kingdom that'll change it into everything it should be.
If I see this of us.
First off, we're going to take all the comforts of home in the 19th century and tack them on to the simple, sweet little ways of you folks here in the 6th century. Why, in no time at all, there'll be no more starving to death. Life will be easier to live. We'll have this place chock full of people, all as happy as kings.
Ah, Sir Boss, what would I not give to see that day?
Nothing to it, Your Majesty. You'll be able to sleep nights. You won't have to go around with all this hardware on your... Oh! Your Majesty, remind me to invent you a nice $12 suit, just like this one.
Oh, heaven
with two pairs of pants.
Heaven forbid, Sir Boss. Unless it be vital to thy project, I would endure much for the welfare of my people.
Well, there's no accounting for taste. You go right ahead with your burglar on, Your Majesty, while I go out through the country and hang up some telephone lines. I'll be back in a few days.
I bid thee haste, and in the meantime, I shall command thy tinkle-tinkle to dwell on every door in the castle so that none may approach me unannounced.
That's that ticket, Your Majesty.
Okay, Sir Boss.
Morning, Saggy Pants. What's he to you?
Master Adversary of the Merry Jape, of the shepherd who possesses the goat, which peradventure boasts not a nose. And upon being approached by a neighboring swineherd, who inquired of him, "Marry, good man, since your goat boasts not a nose, how does it smell?" The shepherd was pleased to reply,
"Terrible!"
I heard that one 1,300 years from now.
Thank you. Well, Merlin, is it about a charm to rent or powerless this devil's tickle-tickles?
Well, I can dwell a day, noble knight. This is powerful magic indeed. Try as I will, this tinkle-tinkle's tongue will not be stilled.
Thou callst thyself a magician. Knowest thou not that while these demons' ding-dongs remain affixed to every portal in Arthur's chambers, our plans concerning the throne of England are forever confounded? Thou callst thy magic great, then magic us out of this dilemma.
I will, fair knight, noble knight. And now to Merlin's latest scheme. Although the castle can no longer be the scene of our attack, the world beyond the castle is happily free from these tinkling alarms which warn the king of interlopers.
But what use is this intelligence when the king remains within these walls?
But there are ways of making the king ride. Huh? Sir Boss is absent these several weeks and cannot gainsay me were I to go to Arthur with a vision of his sister, Morgan Le Fay, in dire distress. Such a vision could not fail but make my liege take to horse and ride toward London. And if he should meet with some mishap on the road, where there is no tinkle-tinkle to warn of ambuscade.
But canst thou summon up such a vision?
I am Merlin.
What thou art to do. The king will pass this way shortly. I caution thee both against failure.
Hello. Hello, Central. Hello, Central.
Hang it. Hello, Central.
Thou hast wrought, and one which will cast fear and dread into the hearts of all who would dare try to...
No, hold it, hold on, Sandy. Save the testimonial for the launching ceremonies. Right now, we have a crisis to cope with. Where's the king? Tell me quick.
Alack and well-a-day, Sir Boss. The king rides to his sister, Morgan Le Fay.
But I can't hear you, Sandy.
The king rides to his sister, Morgan Le Fay. The day was but 2 hours spent when Merlin came to Arthur with news of an alarming vision concerning the king's sister. Arthur immediately took him to horse and is even now upon the road.
Hang it, there's a brace of cutthroats lurking around the bend. Never mind, Sandy, just stick to your guns. Maybe I can head them off the pass.
Assist me to dismount. Well met, Sir Boss.
And has thy journey proved fruitful?
Well, no complaints so far, but I'm sure glad I ran into you. I understand you're calling on your sister.
Aye, it is true, my...
But how canst thou learn so, being absent so long from Camelot?
Oh, I just intercepted Merlin's vision, your majesty.
Oh, reverend magician. And thou belittlest Sir Boss, and whisper to me that his powers are fraudulent? Thou art a false prophet and contemptible.
My liege.
How would you like to run up a little prophecy and show the king what's going to happen to him and what's waiting for him around the corner, huh? I'll give you a hint. What hangs from the lowest branches of a tree, ripe and ready to fall on the king's noggin as he rides by, huh?
I have it, Sabas. Fruit.
A pair of desperados with clubs and dirks.
In sooth?
Nothing was ever soother.
Sir Boss lies, my liege.
Oh, well, if Brother Merlin thinks I lie, let him mosey around the corner and prove it.
And how would that be proof, fair sir? Since it is the king they mean to kill, where is the prophet were I to venture far?
Enough, both. Arthur Pendragon himself will truth the truth or falsity of this report.
No. Now, not so fast, your majesty. We all know you're a brave man. There's no point in killing yourself to prove it.
Stand aside, Sir Boss. This is for royalty.
Now you're making...
It's done, noble knight.
Faithful, Merlin. Thou reap no little reward for thy loyalty when I am king. Let us stand here now and wait until the battle is over, and then we will go forward and identify the remains. And to while the time away, mayhap thou hast not heard the merry jape of the good man who, upon being served a bowl of broth in a tavern, called for the publican.
By my faith, Sir Boss, full many a weary year hath passed since I fought such a fight. Who else dares brave Arthur Pendragon? Let him come forth!
No, hold on, your majesty. This is no time for chivalry. Sir Sagamore's out to kill you. Like as not, he's got 500 cutthroats hiding in the woods between here and Camelot.
Oh.
Now, wait a minute. Hold on. We've got no time to waste. Come here. Get out of those royal robes and into this peasant's
hut.
Now, I'll explain later. Right now, do as I say.
Whereupon, the good man called for mine host. Marry, varlet, but prithee, do observe that fly reposing in my broth. And faith, fair sir, replied mine host, they were so small a creature, surely there were broth enough for both of you.
Oh, well done. Here they are, slaughtered. Here.
No, the thunders, the villains. These are the fellows I paid to hire the deed. Arthur shall not escape me. I will be king.
If ever Arthur and Sir Boss live to return to Camelot, we shall have much to regret.
But wherefore did Arthur doff his crown and his robes?
For evidence. They dressed themselves in the clothing of these two peasants to better to make their way to Camelot.
But how shall we overtake them? Oh, someone comes.
Fair son, will you just?
See thy sword.
Nay, rather draw yours. I am Sir Nantres of Garlet, Knight of the Realm, Squire of the Shire.
Peace, good Nantres of Garlet. This is Sir Sagramore le Desirous, Knight of the Round Table.
Who art thou?
I am Merlin, court sorcerer and advisor to the late King Arthur.
Late King Arthur? King dead?
Observe. Here lies my liege and his prime minister, cut down from ambuscade by two paid assassins.
Who's done this monstrous deed?
Two fierce and evil murderers. Even now they make their way through your realm, seeking to escape to the sea. I bid thee, make haste to chase and capture them.
But how shall I know these villains?
Thou canst not mistake them, for the elder of the two is mad, and upon being crossed will rant and rave and cry out that he is King Arthur himself. Find thee two fleeing slaves, and if the one cries out that he is Arthur Pendragon, do not falter, but hang him forthwith.
Marry, I'll not waste a moment.
Oh,
I'll be off at once.
Good boy.
At once. Give you good day, sir.
Good day.
A noble invention. That great booby will fight King Arthur and Sir Boss, and will hang them. Now, at last, I shall be king. By my head, Sir Boss, he who does travel afoot face a long and weary journey. How long will it take to get to Camelot, say thou?
Oh, what with hiding in the woods while the processions pass, a day or so, I reckon. Hey, on your feet, here comes quality.
Is that a marvel?
Let them come.
But you can't sit there. You're a peasant. You have to assume a humble attitude as they pass.
Why, my head, Sabas, so travel weary am I. I cannot ride.
No, I can't argue now. Here they come.
Dost rise so tardily from thy ease when thou perceivest nobles on the road?
I humbly ask your pardon, noble knight. This old man is my father. He's weak and infirm and affected withal with a dizziness in their head.
Indeed.
Yes, sir.
Well met, then. I have a wondrous cure for dizziness of the head. Where's my whip?
Oh, no, hold on. Dost thou take it on thyself to whip innocent travelers? Back for thy whip, false knight.
Seize him!
Knowest thou not that Arthur Pendragon and his minister Sabas stand before thee?
No, no, he's mad. Pay no attention to him. The old boy's as crazy as a coot.
Oh, so he's mad.
Hey, he's mad.
Oh, then these must be the two Sagamore commissioned us to find. Hear how the old one raves about being king.
Yes.
Huh? Seize him. Seize him at once.
No, I didn't mean that. Now, wait a minute.
King of the Britons, you shall hang by yon elm. That'll put an end to your ranting.
Now we are really in the soup. But I'll say this for you. You gave him the fight, and I may not be very bright, but you make a darn good king, Artie.
Why, Sir Boss, thou dost speak as though these were in very truth our last moments on earth.
Sure than shooting looks like it. What's so funny about it? What are you laughing at?
Yon country squire. In my mind's eye, I can see the look of wonderment upon his face when thou dost decide to end this fandral and blot out the sun.
Stands almost at noon. Hurry with those ropes, villains.
I don't think your majesty should take it so lightly.
Oh, thou wilt not allow harm to come to me, Sir Boss.
I tell you, we're a couple of cooked Indians, unless we can figure a way to free ourselves.
Thou canst free us? These hours we've waited here, I bide it patiently, knowing full well thy silence bespoke the weaving of such charms and enchantments as may most happily affect our release. What hast thou devised, Sabas? An invisible mist, perchance, or some spell to turn our enemies into chipmunks, squirrels, aye, even nutmeg, or other beasts of the forest. I give thee leave to improvise as thou wilt.
I'm much obliged to your majesty. I'm touched by your confidence in
me. What hast thou thought on, Sabas? I give thee leave to blot out the sun.
Now look here, your majesty, you better understand something about my enchantment. It ain't exactly parlor magic, you know. When I rear up and let go, it's got class, but I can't turn it on and off just on the spur of the moment.
But in an emergency.
But I tell you, it needs preparation, and I haven't got my equipment with me. Sure, I'm trying to figure out some way out of this mess, but I'm afraid magic won't do it. What we need now is a miracle.
For so pretty, then, make a miracle.
Oh, I wish I could. Because when it comes to old-fashioned courage, honor, and such, you people got my century-licked hands down. Of course, you've got a lot of superstitions, the same as we have, but I figured I could rub those out once I invented the printing press and the public school system. I somehow hate to hang before the good qualities in you nice people get a chance to pay off.
Now, Sabas, thou must not resign thyself to death. Wilt not try one small enchantment?
No, there's no use kidding ourselves, your majesty. We might just as well face it. Now here, have a cigar.
What hast thou there?
Well, I'll tell you, we're trapped. We're trapped, and for sure. Because if we sit here, yes, hello, boys, if we sit here without doing anything, now here, we're all right, we're right there.
Oh.
Sparrow! Cunning one, thou hast saved us again. Beware, sir. Reduce not thyself and us to cinders.
Tell the folks who we are.
I am Arthur Pendragon, son of Uther Pendragon, knight of the Round Table, master of Camelot, ruler of Britain. And here beside me is Sir Bas, my perpetual minister of state, my right arm, my mind, my royal will. Does anyone here doubt I speak the truth?
Oh, mercy, my liege, mercy. Blast us not all to an amber. We've been deceived. Sir Sorcerer Merlin's deceived us.
Undo our bonds.
Aha! Now, your majesty, the next item on our agenda is to find out what's happening at Camelot, and fast.
Sagramore has just proclaimed himself king. The coronation set for tomorrow with Merlin officiating. In faith, Alisande, I doubt our safety here now.
They have sorrow, they have tears.
We were the boss's friends and helpers. Now Sagramore says he's dead. He and Arthur, killed in a battle against 50 dragons.
Alas, Sir Boss, thou art gone from me forever. Oh. Verily, that my very enchantments mourn thy passing.
Oh, hang the girl. She promised to stay on duty. Hello, Central. Hello, Central.
What manner of device is this,
Sir Boss? Well, it's a device to save our skins in the kingdom. If we can get any service here, of course, the service will be better when I get it organized. Hello, Central.
Why, Sir Boss, thou doth shout full loud, but I doubt if there be any small enough to fit inside this tree and give the answer.
No, your majesty, the person I'm talking to is not in the tree. She's miles away at the castle.
Forsooth, peradventure thy voice be not powerful enough to penetrate so great a distance, therefore we will help thee. I charge thee, on the count of three, join thy voices to mine. One, two, three. Hello,
Central. Oh, no, your majesty, believe me, it doesn't help. But not help.
Can it harm? Now, once again, and this time together. One, two, three. Hello, Central.
Not deaf, not blind, thy instrument beckons me.
Alack, it cannot be, for who be still alive to give it voice?
The boss's orders were to answer it when it rang. Another for thee.
Peckertop Clarence, where in blazes have you been?
It's Sir Boss!
Yes,
Jonas. Sir Boss! Oh. Sir Boss still alive?
Alive? You bet I'm alive. So is the king. Can you hear me, Sandy?
I am there, thankfulness. Oh, may the sun shine ever onward to brighten the gladness that is in my heart, these words.
Oh. It doth talk. The little box doth talk to thee in accents most intelligible.
Hello, Clarence. Sandy, put Clarence on again, will you?
My pleasure, Sir Boss.
Clarence, tell me, what's happening?
Oh, Mary, in a scant few hours from now, Sir Sagramore proposes to proclaim himself king.
Sagramore? King? Arthur Pendragon wearies of these games. Sir Boss, I bid thee devise an enchantment to reduce Camelot to a lump of clay, together with Sir Sagramore and all who will betray me.
Oh, now, your majesty, don't get riled up. Clarence, now listen to me. I want you to do a favor for me. Go into my bedroom and get that wooden box that's under the bed. Then carry it to the castle entrance. That's all. This is a special bit of magic I've saved for a real emergency, and it looks as if this is it. Your majesty, come on. We're going to get your kingdom back.
Now proceed with the coronation of Sir Sagramore le Desirous as King of Britain under the express wishes of the dying Arthur Pendragon. According to chivalric code, are there any here who would bring their voices against the ascendance of King Sagramore onto the throne? I'm ordered to pause here for reply. To the first asking, there was no response. I am now ordered to command the second asking. Are there any here who would raise their voices in defiance against King Sagramore's assumption?
Nentres of Garlath, friend to Sagramore, the desirous, waits audience upon the new king.
I'm here, Sir Boss.
Garlath, you got the box?
Here, gentle sir.
What is that?
That's bad medicine for traitors. Now take, we're safe. Put those duds on, Your Majesty. Here, hold that, Clarence.
To the second asking, there is no response. I am ordered to pronounce the final asking. Sagramore the Desirous as King of Britain.
Is the floor open for discussion of that motion?
The boss speaks.
The boss.
The boss, the boss and the king. Out of the way, Saggy Pants. Ascend the throne, Your Majesty. The traffic is clear.
Once more thou hast saved my kingdom in time of distress. Sabas, approach the throne that thy king may embrace thee.
But oblige, Your Majesty.
At every turn thou hast confounded me. Never shalt thou foil me.
Stop that nonsense, son.
Thy charms can hurt me not, for I have Varin's protection. Prepare to die, Varin!
That one won't bother you anymore, Your Majesty.
Sabas, thou art wounded.
No, it's only a scratch. I'll be all right since my head clears.
Thou'st reckon without Merlin.
Oh, no. I'm willing to let bygones be bygones.
Thou belittlest my power and call me humbug. Thou live to rue thy ridicule. Sleep, Sir Boss. Sleep in dreamlessness for full 13 centuries.
Now, I'm Hank Morgan from Hartford, Connecticut, and I don't take any stock in charms and enchantments. Sleep for 1,300 years, don't make me laugh.
Sir Boss.
Thou dost stagger and pass thy hand before thine eyes.
Sir Boss.
Sir Boss, good Sir
Noble Boss.
Noble Boss. Noble Boss. Sir Boss.
Sir Boss.
Sir Boss. Sir Boss.
Sir Boss.
Came running at me, and I just had time to shoot from the hip. Not a bad shot at that. Oh, sir, I'm sleepy. I'm fugit, as the fellow says. Yes, it's getting late. I'm real sleepy. Way I feel now, I'd be glad for 1,300 more years of sleep. Give me a good end. Well, sir.